this cartoonish version of Genghis Khan's political curve by saying that you either surrender totally to us, or you'll be wiped out, you'll be obliterated. The word obliteration of Iran was used several times by the Trump administration. There's echo of that, total surrender, or you'll be wiped out, by Boris Johnson's phrases, do or die. And we have seen what that has already done to the Tory party, the purge of 21 so-called moderate Tories, and we know what that will do to this country if Boris Johnson will have its own Brexit, no big Brexit in this country. So there's this confluence of interest by the right-wing Trump administration, Boris Johnson administration, and some other right-wing administration all over the world, to go for this maximum pressure on Iran, and because there's no exit strategy, because Iran will never surrender under pressure. That has been made very, very clear by Iran. Iran has said repeatedly that it has never sought nuclear weapons. It will never seek nuclear weapons. And this is a credible statement, because when the Western governments, when the Western companies were supporting Saddam Hussein with chemical weapons to be used against Iranian civilians, Iranian soldiers, and Iranian revolutionary guards, the leader of Iran, Ayatollah Khomeini at the time, refused to accept that Iran would create its own chemical weapons to retaliate in kind. So the fact, so this is Iran in action. Iran has shown that it will, because of the backlog against nuclear weapons, it will never seek nuclear weapons. So this is just a pretext to put more pressure on Iran with the idea of regime change that the neocons have been dreaming for years. Of course, Iran has been under sanctions, destabilization program, and imposed war by Saddam Hussein, supported by the West for ages and so on and so forth, for 40 years, right? But now, this is reaching its climax. And it is vital that we organize a mass mobilization, mass campaign in the UK against the Tory government. The Tory government should renounce its participation in the military armada in the Persian Gulf. It must withdraw immediately its fleet, its navies from the US-led coalition in the Persian Gulf. That's the first step that they have to take. And we should fight for the Tory government to not be complicit with the US administration for imposing these sanctions on Iran and start to implement and be compliant with its own obligations under the Iran Treaty by safeguarding Iran's economic and trade interests, by buying Iranian oil, by safeguarding Iran's bank transactions, which has been violated by the US administration, so that Iran can have the budget that it needs to pay its employees, and the country can survive this maximum pressure strategy by the United States. We have to do this for the good of the whole of the humanity, in order to save our planet from another, this time a much more catastrophic war in the Middle East with all the international implications that we have. Thank you very much.